I'm sorry that I'm all wet. I just got out of the shower, but I want to say there's times in life where your blood boils, you just get too hot, you say a lot of things to people that make you mad. And some Ranger fans make me mad. It's like, you know, they think just because, oh, you know, I'm sitting there defending my team, you know, that I don't know about baseball, that, you know, they know more about baseball than me because the Rangers are better. Me being an Astros fan, I'm always going to be Astros, number one, all the time, always. But I've always been one to try to join the two cities together, you know, Dallas and Houston. And don't say that the Rangers aren't considered Dallas because they're right outside of Dallas. Dallas fans, watch the Rangers. They're considered Dallas in some way. But anyways, to the good Ranger fans, I'm really sorry that for some of these videos you're about to see, but I'm going to show you that Ranger fans and Astros fans go through the same heartbreak. So let's stop biting each other's heads off and be friends. So first off, I'm going to show you an Astros heartbreak. Okay, here we go.
When it's your job to protect the world's greatest nation.
Sorry about the ad. Hang on 1 second. Before you guys think that this is easy for me to watch, this is actually really hard for me to watch. Everybody knows, every true Astro fan knows that if we would beat the Royals last year in this series, we might have had our only legitimate shot of winning a World Series in a long time. It hurt. It really hurt. So here you guys go.
ALDS in Houston. The Astros leading the Royals 2-1 in their best of
credit
five series.
Goes to MLB, of course. I'm not trying to copyright any videos. I just want to let y'all know that.
Lance McCullers. Here's the 1-2. Swing and a fly ball. Deep into right field. Back goes Springer. It is gone. Salvador Perez. It's an opposite field home run to right. And the Royals lead 2-0 in the second inning. Carlos Correa, a swing and a drive to left. And this game is... That's a nice field for Carlos Correa. Getting caught in the bat before Ventura to go up there. First pitch, get a fastball out over the plate. Not miss it. Tie up the score. For a 21-year-old kid, we've talked about this all series. This kid has the composure of a 20-year veteran. I don't think Ventura will be going to Salvador Perea. Into the corner. Springer can run. Gary Pettis is sending him home. 3-2 Houston. Ryan Madsen extracted out of the Kansas City bullpen. Here's Carlos Correa. Great day so far. There goes the runner. Taken over this game. 21 years old. Now Madsen facing Colby Rasmus. Rasmus follows up! And that one is gone! The only question on Rasmus was it going to stay fair? You saw him hit the foul pole, the fair pole, the foul pole, whatever you want to call it, to give him a home run and make this crowd go insane. The line keeps moving still. A nightmare situation for an Astros team that had grabbed a 6-2 lead moments earlier. You know you've got 2 innings left in your life for your season when you're down 4 and you don't want it to go walk away. You're going to grind, and they are grinding. And now Lorenzo Cain's up with a chance to tie the game. The 1-1 to Cain. Swing and a base hit into left. It'll score at least one. Here's Rios to score easily. And the Royals, as they've done all year long, keep the line moving. It's a 3-run lead for Houston. And it's gotten uncomfortable enough for A.J. Hinch to make an immediate move for Tony Sipp. Here's Kendrys Morales now, the switch hitter batting from the right side. And now Sipp to the belt and to the plate. Breaking ball, ground ball up the middle. Correa, he misplayed it. The ball goes into center field. 2-run score, and this game is tied. And Carlos Correa, in the blink of an eye, goes from hero to goat. That'll bring up Alex Gordon with the bases loaded in a tie game and only one away. Gordon bounces it to second. Altuve gets two.
It's really hard to watch the second time.
The Royals have scored 5 in the 8th inning, and they lead 7-6. One gone for
Fields. Now it's Eric Hosmer. Kansas City in elimination games, 8-1 in their last 9. Their only loss, game 7 of the World Series last year to Madison Bumgarner. A high drive into deep right center. Gomez can only watch it, and that one is gone. Eric Hosmer's last 2 at-bats of this series have been big ones. An RBI single in the 8th, a 2-run dinger in the 9th. Carlos Gomez represents the last chance for Houston to try to keep this one alive.
And of course, you know, it would be Carlos Gomez.
Orlando makes the catch, and Kansas City comes back in game 4. And the Royals have forced a game 5 in Kansas City on Tuesday night.
Wade Ouch. Davis with his first career 6-out save. The Royals score 7.
Ouch. Now, for you cocky Ranger fans, the ones that don't want to be our friends, for, like I said, for the good ones like Dummyman777, Fluff97, Ray Estrada, I'm sorry to show you that. And, you know, a couple ones I've met along the way, I'm really sorry to show you this. I really am. But this is why we should all be friends. This is a hole at bat. Hang on. See, so what's the complaining about? How are you guys better because we both got eliminated in 5 games last year? It hurts to both of us. We should stick together. Thank you guys for watching this video. This series will continue tomorrow. This is a series on trying to join the two Texas teams together and be friends and support one another when we're not playing each other. That's all I'm trying to say is we need to stop ripping each other's heads off and support each other. Who's better? Who cares? See you guys later. Stay fly, YouTube. Just we're 1-on-1 out. I will see you guys later. Remember, God bless Texas and stay fly. See you guys later.